Hi everyone, how is it going? My name is Sinet Frenette and welcome to my YouTube channel. So for today's video guys, I am going to share with you my 76 day journey in processing my I-751 or the petition to remove condition on permanent residency. Yes guys, the first ever YouTube video that I've uploaded is actually how I compiled my I-751 pocket. On this video guys, I've shown what are the major forms that I have filled up and completed, the supporting documents that I included, and some important information in regards to removal of condition. So if you guys are about to file for your paperwork, please feel free to watch my video and I hope you will get an idea on how to compile for your I-751. All right, so going back, yes guys, you heard it right. My journey to remove condition only took 76 days. Like, no joke, I feel so lucky, I feel so blessed that this journey wasn't really stressful. So I am just so happy and glad guys that there was no any complication or anything that happened to my case. I didn't receive any RFE or request for evidence, didn't attend for an interview, it just automatically approved. Okay, so for this video guys, I'm going to share with you my timeline on this journey, so stay with me. Going back, September 24, guys, USCIS Lockbox Facility in Phoenix, Arizona actually received my paperwork. So I used UPS and I availed their overnight service so it get there like the next day. It was a little bit expensive, but it was worthy because I didn't want to waste so much time just waiting for my package to be delivered to the USCIS Lockbox Facility. I used our personal check to pay for my application, which was $680 by that time. And just a tips guys, please, before filing for your application, always double check the updated current filing fee and also the filing address, because from time to time guys, they just change it. So September 26, our payment was processed. I checked our bank account and the $680 was already deducted. Okay, it's the time that, okay, they already accepted my application because they already took out the amount, the application fee on our bank account. September 27 of 2020, I received an SMS notification. So if you guys want to receive an email or a text message notification in regards to your case, you can actually fill out the form G1145 so that you are giving authority to USCIS to give you a text message and email whenever there is a progress or an update on your case. So I submitted the G1145. That's why I got the SMS notification, and on that text message it actually shows there my case number, which starts with three letters, SRC, and that means that my case was processed in Texas Service Center. I live in Houston, so my case was in Texas Service Center. Receipt number is actually the number that you will use to track your case status online, and there's several application guys that you can use or you can download. I do recommend the case status portal of USCIS.gov website, and also the one that I've used is the USCIS case. It's an app, you can download that at Google Play or in Apple Store. Automatically notify you if there's an update regarding your case. Okay, so September 30, like 3 days after I received the text, I already received my 18 months extension letter. So basically when the time comes that your green card is expired and your I-751 is not yet approved, that 18 months extension letter will serve as your proof that you can still continue working and also you can travel outside the US, which I actually did. My 2 years green card expired first week of December, and I actually traveled outside the US, and I came back with an expired 2 years green card and just my 18 months extension letter. And thank God everything was smooth when I presented that to the immigration officer when I entered the US, and there was no problem at all. So if you guys plan to travel while your 2 years green card is expired, just make sure that you bring that 18 months extension letter with you guys. Moving forward, October 29, a month after I received my 18 months extension letter, it notifies me that my case was updated to show fingerprints were taken. So I didn't attend any biometrics appointment, guys. I didn't receive any letter. Basically, they have reused my biometrics when I filed for my I-485 or the adjustment of status when I filed for my 2 years green card. So they just reused my biometrics. I am not too sure why it happened, but I'm thinking one of the factors is COVID, the pandemic that is going on all over the world right now. December 9, a month after, I got another notification saying that new card is being produced. Yay! Like, I was like the happiest woman on earth that day. I feel so relieved, like the pressure was out of my chest. I was just so happy. Christmas came so early for me. So December 9, new card was being produced. And December 10, the status changed online again, and it says that the case was approved. Like, from then on, it just went up so fast, guys. So December 11, it notified me that the card was mailed to me. And then December 15, the card was delivered to me by my post office. So the letter, the I-797 notice of action, which is the approval letter, and my green card, my 10 years green card, came at the same time. On this letter, I'm gonna share with you guys some of it. So, I-797 notice of action, it reads your receipt number, the receive date, and it says here, congratulations, USCIS approved your request to remove condition on your permanent resident status. You are deemed to be a lawful resident of the United States as of the date of your original admission or adjustment of status. You should receive a new permanent resident card, form I-551, also known as green card, within 60 days. Your card will include a mailer, form I-797D, with important information about your status and responsibilities, as well as permanent services available to you. So, yep, so that's the main highlight of the I-797 notice of action letter, guys. And then on this paper, I was so excited, so I already opened it. And on this paper, this is where my green card was attached. Yes, guys. So this is my new green card now. I believe that this journey is almost over. So the next step is, as y'all know, if you want to be a naturalized, be a citizen of the United States, so which I think I'm going to do that, is before my 3 years anniversary as a permanent resident, which will be sometime around September of 2021. And I'm going to make another video, guys, how will I file my citizenship. And I'm hoping and praying that the process will be as smooth as this. That was my 76 days journey in my petition to remove condition on my permanent residency. In just 76 days, guys, I still can't believe I've already gotten 10 years green card. Tips that I can give to all future filers for petition to remove condition is, first, prepare as early as you can. Like, if you guys got time and you thought you can think of a document that might help in this petition, just get that ready. Like I actually started preparing and gathering some documents 6 months before I filed my paperwork. So that gave me a lot of time for me to think of what supporting documents should I include, what else am I missing. So on the day or on the week that you're about to send your paperwork all you have to do is like double checking. Second is double check all the information. Like before you ship your paperwork, guys, make sure that all the information that you have put in your forms are all correct. Do not forget to sign your form, because USCIS will return your application if you didn't sign it. So you and your spouse has a portion there where you have to sign. For the third one is you sign up for the USPS Informed Delivery. It helped me a lot tracking my card, because the least thing that you want to happen is you lose your card, like almost to getting your card and then it will just get lost. And then the last tip that I can give you guys is be patient and have faith. Every case is different. It's being processed differently. Our cases are assigned to different service centers, so we have different processing times. But at the end of the day, it will come. It will be granted to you guys, as long as you know that you did everything correctly, everything is true, then you don't have to worry about. We just really have to have faith that this journey will also come to an end positively. So there you have it, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope this video will give you a little bit of insight on how I-751 application is being processed. I hope that you have an idea now how will the timeline be. And if you guys have any questions, please feel free to comment down below. And also, I'm going to put the link of the videos that I have made in regards to my petition to I-751. If you are one of the future ROC filers, good luck in advance, and thank you guys for watching. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and click the notification bell for you to be updated every time I upload a new video. Thank you so much.